Hello and warm welcome to all of you. Dear students, today I am here with part 4 of economic chapter. Chapter number 3, poverty as a challenge. In the previous lecture, we had discussed that how poverty is seen by social scientists. In that, we had discussed social exclusion and vulnerability to poverty. So, social exclusion is a process through which individuals or group of individuals are excluded from facilities, benefits, and opportunity that other people of the society enjoy. Vulnerability to poverty means it describes the greater possibility of certain community. Here you have to keep in mind the member of backward class. Certain communities or individuals such as widow and handicapped person, certain community or individuals of becoming or remaining poor in coming years. This is known as vulnerability to poverty. So, after discussing the social indicator and common indicator of the poverty, even social exclusion and vulnerability to poverty, we can say that poverty is a situation in which a person is unable to get the minimum basic necessities of life. I am giving you the definition of poverty. Poverty is a situation in which a person is unable to get the minimum basic necessities. Now, which are the minimum basic necessities for the person? Basic necessities of life, that is food, clothing and shelter for his or her sustenance. This situation we can call a poverty. Again, I am repeating. Poverty is a situation in which a person is unable to get the basic minimum necessities such as food, clothing and shelter for his or her sustenance. This situation we can call a poverty. Here you have to keep in mind why person is unable to get basic necessities for his or her sustenance. So you have to remember the common indicator. You have to keep in mind the social indicator of the poverty as well as social exclusion and vulnerability to poverty. Now today we are going to discuss poverty line. At the center of the discussion on poverty is usually the concept of poverty line. As I have given you the definition of the poverty, when person is unable to get his or her basic necessities of the life, we can call that person is a poor. So when we are discussing about the poverty, so poverty line is in center of all the discussion. Common method used to measure poverty is based on the income or consumption level. How can we measure the poverty? how can we say that the person is living in poverty? So the common method to measure poverty is level of income and level of consumption. A person is considered poor if his or her income or consumption level falls below a given minimum level necessary to fulfill basic needs. When person is unable to get minimum income or to conserve minimum level, so we can call that person is poor. It means that a person is called poor if his or her income is below the minimum level. Person is called poor when his or her income below the minimum level to fulfill basic necessities of the life. Now here the question, the basic necessities of life is different at different times and in different countries. Therefore, poverty line may vary with time and place. Each country uses an imaginary line that is considered appropriate for its existing level of development and is accepted minimum social norm. In each country, the poverty line is different. All the countries are using an imaginary line to measure poverty. And this poverty line may differ into different countries. For example, a person not having a car in the United States may be considered poor. But in India, owning a car is still considered a luxury. This is a very important thing. As I am explaining you, poverty line may differ at time and place. In different country, poverty line is different. It is an imaginary line used by the country to measure the poverty. So here you have to keep in mind, not having a car in United States means in America is considered as poverty. In contrast to that, owning a car in India is considered still a luxury. Means person is not living in poverty. So this way we can say that poverty line may differ at time and place. In determining the poverty line in India, minimum level of food requirement, clothing, footwear, fuel and light, educational and medical requirement, etc. are determined for subsistence. When we determining a poverty line in India, so we have to keep in mind what is the minimum requirement of the food, What is minimum requirement of clothing, footwear, fuel, light, education facilities, medical facilities for the sustenance of the people in India? These physical quantities are multiplied by the prices in rupees. All these physical quantities, food, clothing, center, medical facilities, education facilities, all these physical quantities are multiplied by prices in the rupees. The present formula for food requirement by estimating the poverty line is based on the desired caloric requirement. The present formula to measure the poverty in our country is based on the desired calorie requirement for Indian people. How much calorie required for a person per day? Here, the food items such as cereal, pulses, vegetable, milk, oil, sugar, etc. together provide these needed calories. And we are getting these calories from the food, milk, vegetable, cereals, sugar, all these food items provide the needed calorie for our sustenance. The calorie needs vary depending on age, sex and type of work that a person does. Even the calorie requirement is also different, depend on the age of the person, depend on the age, sex, male, female, even it depends on the type of the work. In comparison to children and aged adult, working people require more calorie. In comparison to female, male require more calorie. Same way, it also depends on the type of work. If person is doing hard work into open farm, require more calorie in comparison to that person who is doing office work under the fan, under the AC. So the calorie requirement for the person is depend on age, sex and type of work. The accepted average calorie requirement in India is 2400 calorie per person per day in rural area. The accepted calorie requirement for Indian people is 2400 calorie for rural people and 2100 calories per person per day in urban area. Accepted calorie requirement for Indian people in rural area is 2400 calories per person per day. On the other hand, in urban area, 2100 calories per person per day. So here you have the question. The calorie requirement of urban people and rural people is also different. Why? Since the people living in rural area engage themselves in more physical work, calorie requirement in rural area are considered to be higher than urban area. Because rural people are more engaged in physical work, they are working in open farm, They are engaged in hard work. So that's why accepted calorie for rural people 2400 calories per person per day. On the other hand, the urban people, they are engaged in more manual work. They are working in offices. So that's why 2100 calories for the urban people. The monetary expenditure per capita needed for buying this calorie requirement in terms of the food grain etc. is revised periodically, taking into consideration the rise in the price. The monetary expenditure to get this much of calorie is revised periodically as there is rise and fall into prices. To get this much of calorie, how much money is required? It depends on the prices of the food item. On the basis of this calculation, for the year 2011-12, poverty line for person was fixed at ₹816 per month for the rural area and ₹1,000 for the urban area. As per this calculation, the poverty line was fixed ₹816 per person in rural area and ₹1,000 for the urban person as per the report of 2011-12. Means, as per the report of 2011-12, if person is unable to earn less than 816 and less than 1000 in rural and urban area, person is considered poor. Here you might have the question, the calorie requirement of the rural people is more in comparison to urban people, but the poverty line for the rural people is 816. On the other hand, poverty line for the urban people is 1000 rupees. Why such difference is there? So despite less calorie requirement, the higher amount for urban area has been fixed because of the high prices of many essential products in urban area. Calorie requirement is less in urban area, but poverty line is set more in comparison to rural area, because in urban area the high prices of these essentials are there. These all food requirement, essential, they are getting with higher prices in comparison to rural area. That's why the poverty line of the rural area is different from the urban area, because urban people, they are getting all these food essential with the higher prices. In this way, in the year 2011-12, family of 5 members living in rural area and earning less than about ₹4,080 per month will be below the poverty line. As per this figure, 816 per person per month in rural area. So the family of 5 members, it means that if in rural area the family of 5 member, if they are earning less than 4,080 rupees, so we can call the family is living below poverty line. Family is living in below poverty line. Similarly, family of 5 in urban area would need minimum rupees 5,000 per month to meet their basic requirement. In urban area, poverty line is 1,000 per person per month. So if 5 members are there in the family and family is unable to earn 5,000 or they are earning less than 5,000, so the urban family, we can consider they are poor. They are living below poverty line. The poverty line is estimated periodically by conducting sample survey. These surveys are carried out by National Sample Survey Organization. This poverty line is estimated periodically. Periodically, normally after every 5 years, by conducting a survey, and these surveys are organized, conducted by National Sample Survey Organization. So NSSO, conducting a survey to estimate poverty line periodically. To estimate poverty line normally after every 5 years. However, for making comparison between developing countries, many international organizations like World Bank use a uniform standard for the poverty line. Minimum availability of the equivalent of $1.90 per person per day. But for uniformity all over the world, international organization like World Bank, they measure the poverty by uniform standard for the poverty line by minimum availability of equivalent of rupees $1.90 per person per day. It means that if the person is not able to earn minimum $1.90 per day, person is called poor or the person is living below poverty line. Equivalent to $1.90. In our country, currency in the form of rupees. So equivalent to 1.90, at present $1 equivalent to 74-75 rupees. So it means that 1.90 means if person is not able to earn 135-140 rupees per day, person is called poor. As I told you, in different country, poverty line is different. Poverty line may different as per the place and time. But this uniform standard is given by World Bank. If person is unable to earn $1.90 per day, person is called poor. Hope you all are clear with the poverty line, minimum calorie requirement for the person in urban area as well as rural area. Poverty line set 116 rupees per person per month in rural area, 1,000 rupees per person in urban area. With this, I would like to conclude my today's lecture. Thank you very much for your cooperation. Inshallah, we will meet again very soon. Thank you again.